Welcome to section Celery for managing your distributed task queue. In this section, we will learn how to use Celery framework for building distributed task queue, an important component of distributed apps. By the end of this section, you would have learned the Celery concepts and seen some real life examples. Welcome to the first video of this section, Celery concepts. In this video, we're going to talk about what Celery is and how to get started with using it. Celery is an asynchronous task queue, job queue based on distributed message passing. It is focused on real-time operation but supports scheduling as well. The execution units called tasks are executed concurrently on a single or more worker servers using multiprocessing, eventlet or gevent. Tasks can execute asynchronously in the background or synchronously, that is, wait until ready. Celery is used in production systems to process millions of tasks a day by a lot of companies in the world. To start using Celery, we need to install it first. We can install Celery by executing command pip install Celery from the command line. Next, Celery requires a solution to send and receive messages. Usually, this comes in the form of a separate service called a message broker. There are several choices available. One of the most popular and default is RabbitMQ. It is available at this URL. RabbitMQ is a feature complete, stable, durable, and easy to install. It's an excellent choice for a production environment. RabbitMQ is available for all kinds of operating systems at this URL. If you are using Ubuntu or Debian, you can install RabbitMQ by executing the command sudo apt-get install RabbitMQ server. When the command completes, the broker will already be running in the background, ready to move messages for you. Don't worry if you're not running Ubuntu or Debian, you can still go to the RabbitMQ website to find similarly simple installation instructions for other platforms, including Microsoft Windows. RabbitMQ is not your only option as far as message brokers are concerned. Here is a comparison of few of them. RabbitMQ is the default message broker in Celery and requires minimum configuration. Experimental brokers may be functional, but they don't have dedicated maintainers. Missing monitor support here means that the transport does not implement events, and as such, Flower, Celery Event, Celery Mon, and other event-based monitoring tools won't work. Remote control means the ability to inspect and manage workers at runtime using the Celery Inspect and Celery Control commands and other tools using the Remote Control API. As you can see, our RabbitMQ message broker has been installed and it is ready to use, which we are going to do it in the next video. This concludes this video. In this video, we learned what Celery is and how to get started with using it.